गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग प्रदीप सर।
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू।
स्वप्ना मैम, यू कैन स्टार्ट।
Welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us for today's webinar, Opportunities in Indian Defence, presented by retired Lieutenant Colonel Pradeep Brahmankar. Future is always a challenge that forces individuals to stay on their cutting edge, constantly re-examining skills and being ever watchful of the latest trends, problems and opportunities affecting society. As students, we go through so much of confusion in which career path to choose. Not only do we have trouble with which career and stream to choose, but also go through an emotional and physical roller coaster ride. Each one of us contributes to the nation in some way, yet none plays a more important role in this than the defense forces of our nation. So, the best way to make a career in defense is with the right career guidance. Before we get started, I'd like to inform that if you have any questions during the presentation, please type them in the chat box. We'll bring them up during the presentation and we also have time for questions at the end. Now, without further ado, we will turn the time over to our eminent speaker for today. Lieutenant Colonel Pradeep Brahmankar, an engineering graduate from Government College of Engineering, Pune, of the 1980 batch, has served in private sector in two reputed organizations, namely Perfect Circle Victor Limited Nashik for 1 year and Shivaji Works Limited Solapur for 2 years. The officer did MBA from Pune University Department of Commerce and Management Sciences during the year 1995-97 and has specialized in the field of human resources and personnel management. Colonel Brahmankar joined Indian Military Academy, Dehradun on 8th February 1984 and was commissioned in the Corps of EME, Electronics and Mechanical Engineers, on 15th December 1984. He has served in various parts of the country, from Siachen Glacier in north to Chennai in the south, and from Firozpur in west to Siliguri Darjeeling in the east. During the year 1989-90, he served in Sri Lanka as a part of the Indian Peacekeeping Force and was posted in Palali near Jaffna. The officer also participated in Operation Vijay and Operation Trident. He has performed regimental duties in various EME units and has been a staff officer at Corps Headquarters in Northern Sector and has been an instructor at Military College of EME, Secunderabad, Andhra Pradesh. The officer took premature retirement after completing 21 years service in the Indian Army. He is the director of Apex Careers in Pune. The institute trains students for NDA entrance examination, CDS written exams, AFCT, that is the Air Force Common Admission Test, INET, Indian Navy entrance test, and SSB interviews. The institute also conducts a special 2-year course for science students for NDA preparation known as 11-12 plus NDA course. Apex Careers has to its credit more than 400 students who have been commissioned as officers in the Indian Armed Forces, of which around 150 have joined the prestigious NDA, National Defense Academy, and over 30 girls and 370 boys have been commissioned in the Army, Navy, and Air Force. May I now welcome Pradeep sir to please take over the presentation.
Sir,
Good morning, dear students and teachers. I would start off basically with the presentation, and later on we will have the question answer session round. So now I will be speaking about the various careers in defense, as to how we should proceed in making these careers. First of all, I'll be covering the National Defense Academy, about the eligibility, when can one apply, the written exam, conduct of the UPSC exam, how to prepare, the results of this exam, what after passing NDA written, what are the intermediary steps.
Sir, your microphone is on mute, sir. Sir, your microphone is on mute.
Pradeep, sir. Oh, can you just unmute yourself? Actually, your microphone is mute. Hello, Pradeep, sir. Actually, we cannot hear you. Can you just unmute yourself?
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay. Should I start the presentation again?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I'll present the your PPT. You just fix it.
Okay. I can control the presentation. No problem.
Okay. No problem.
So I will go start with the what are the things that I am going to cover. First of all, the National Defense Academy eligibility for the NDA and Naval Academy exam. When can one apply? The written examination, the conduct of the UPSC exam, how can one prepare, the results of the UPSC, what after passing the written, then the intermediary steps involved, and the training at the National Defense Academy. We now move on to the eligibility criteria. First of all, the age. The age requirement is 16 and a half to 19 and a half years. Sex, only males are eligible to apply. As far as the army is concerned, a boy from any stream from 12th who has passed 12th is eligible. However, for the Navy and the Air Force, the boy needs to be from the science background with physics and maths as a major subjects. The written examination has just been conducted on 18th of April. The next exam would be on 5th September. So all those students who are now studying in class 12th are eligible to apply for this examination, which is on 5th of September. However, the forms can be filled in the month of June. Now, what does this NDA exam consist of? It has basically two papers. First paper is the mathematics, which is 2.5 hours duration, carrying 300 marks. It will have 120 questions of mathematics. The paper 2 will be general ability test, again of 2.5 hours, and will carry 600 marks. This question paper will have 150 questions. All the papers will be objective type questions only. The syllabus for the written examination is as follows. For the maths, you have got the entire syllabus of class 11th as well as 12th. Like say for algebra, you have algebra, matrices and determinants, trigonometry, analytical geometry, differential and integral calculus, differential equations, vector algebra, statistics, and probability. The second paper has two sections in it, two parts. The part A is of 200 marks, which has 50 questions of English. So basically, it is purely the English grammar part only. Then the part B is general knowledge. Marks are 400. This part B will have all the subjects that we've studied. It's physics, chemistry, general science, social studies, geography, current events. Now, the students of class 9th and 10th should understand that whatever they are learning now is required for them, which will be covered there in the NDA exam. So they should preserve their books when they prepare for the NDA. How can one prepare for this examination? Option one, join the institute which prepares for NDA entrance. Now, for preparation of the NDA entrance examination, there are institutes like Apex Careers we are preparing. Then there is one more institute which is known as Services Preparatory Institute. Option two, prepare yourself. How can you prepare yourself? As far as mathematics paper one is concerned, you can concentrate on the 11th and 12th maths. Then the other subjects, you study from the basics I just mentioned. Your 8th, 9th, 10th syllabus is more than sufficient. As far as English paper, English part of the paper 2 is concerned, you can solve the NDA exam English papers. I just mentioned about joining an institute which prepares you for the NDA. Firstly, the SPI Aurangabad, Services Preparatory Institute. This institute is basically run by the government of Maharashtra to prepare boys for a career in the Indian Armed Forces, more specific to getting into the prestigious National Defense Academy, Khadakwasla, Pune. The next aim is to mold the cadets to become good citizens of the country. Entry to SPI Aurangabad. Boys appearing in 10 board exam are eligible to apply. The next point is the boy should be domiciled from Maharashtra state. This is for entry to SPI. The admission forms will be available on www.spiaurangabad.com. This application form correctly filled should be sent along with 450 rupees to the institute, which is supposed to be paid by debit card or credit card or net banking. You also have got to follow all the instructions which are given on the website while submitting the form. Last date for submission of application form is likely to be 15th of December. Why I have made a mention of likely to be, because till last 2 years, 2 years back, the last date used to be 15th of February. However, last year they changed the entire procedure because of the pandemic, and they had given 27th January as the last date of submission of form. So therefore, I have mentioned that it could be 15th of December. Last year, the examination was conducted on 14th of Jan. So I mentioned online test will be conducted in Mumbai, Pune, Nashik, Kolhapur, Nagpur, Latur, Amravati and Aurangabad in January or February. Last time it was conducted on 14th of Feb. Now we do not know next time when it will be conducted. Therefore, I mentioned in January / February. The results of the written test announced after the exam. The SPI written test will have two papers as similar to the NDA papers, wherein the first paper will be of mathematics, 75 marks, 75 questions, and the second paper of general ability tests of 75 marks. This question paper will purely be based on the 10th board syllabus, state board syllabus, or the CBSE syllabus. Personal interview will be conducted for all those who qualify the written test, and the final results will be announced after the interviews. The training at SPI Aurangabad. Why I am giving a lot of importance to this SPI, because there have been a number of students from this institute getting selected for the National Defense Academy. Therefore, I am covering this part, giving a lot of stress on this. Boys admitted in SPI are simultaneously admitted in Padma Shri Shankar Bapu Apegaonkar School in Aurangabad for 11 science. They are prepared for the NDA written examination. In that academy or the institute, regular PT and games are conducted to ensure physical fitness. And SSB interviews training are also given to the cadets who clear the written examination. Training at SPI Aurangabad. Train the cadets to get accustomed to the training given in NDA both mentally as well as physically. So far, more than 500 ex-cadets from the institute are officers in the Indian Armed Forces. The email ID is mentioned. sanchalaksp@gmail.com, and the phone numbers have also been given here: 040-238-1370, and the mobile number is 7218668250. Now, results of the NDA written. Now we've switching over back to NDA. I mentioned about the SPI because one of the institutes which prepares and which is a very good institute, which is in Aurangabad, is SPI. Okay. After that, in the entire Maharashtra, you have got one more institute, which is Sainik School Satara. However, the admission to that school is given in class 6th and once again in class 9th for a few seats. After 10th, there is only one institute which is having wonderful results, and that is SPI Aurangabad. Sainik School Satara also has good results, but the admission is in class 6. The next institute, which is a private institute, is Apex Careers, which has sent over 160 students to National Defence Academy. Now, this institute also is running for the last 16 years. Now, the results of the NDA written likely to be announced 1 or 2 months after the examination. Okay, they are announced on the website UPSC website, that is www.upsc.gov.in. What after passing the NDA written? Now this is all those students who give the written, appear for the written, and they clear the written. What after that? They will be given an SSB interview call letter within a fortnight. Okay, for the SSB interviews also, you get to know the center, and then you have to opt for a particular date. The choices, the dates are given by the center, and you opt for one of those dates. Now you should start the interview preparation immediately by joining a reputed institute giving SSB training. Friends, Apex Careers too gives training for the SSB interviews. Now, in case the students who qualify the SSB, after that, what happens? Immediately after qualifying the SSB, there is a medical exam which is followed by the SSB interview for only those students who qualify the SSB. Now, as far as the army is concerned, if you get selected, immediately the SSB, the medical examination takes place. For the Air Force, what they do, they give you a particular date so that the students go back to their homes and report once again, maybe after 15 days or 20 days. They've given you a specific date and you're supposed to report on that date for medical examination at the concerned hospital. Okay. The final merit is likely to be in the month of November or May. Now the entire schedules have changed, but this has been the standard timings, that is to be November and May. Okay. Now, if the merit is in November, then the boy is supposed to join in the first last week of December, and the course commences on 2nd of January. However, now, due to the pandemic, there has been a lot of postponement of these courses, and the latest course which has commenced has started in the month, reporting has happened in 2nd of April, 1st / 2nd of April. And our last student who just joined was on 23rd of 2 days back, that is Friday, 23rd of May. So, 23rd of April. And so the things are getting postponed over a period of time. All right. You can join NDA after receipt of the joining instructions. Now, what does NDA train you? How does NDA train you? What happens at NDA? You get a 3 years military and academic training. Okay. And on completion of these 3 years of training, the cadets will be awarded the BA or the BSc or the BSc computers or the BTech degree. Now, all those cadets who are from the Air Force and the Naval streams, they will be getting a BTech degree. Whereas the cadets of the Army stream are getting the BA or the BSc degree. This degree has been awarded by the Jawaharlal Nehru University, Delhi. Further training is at Indian Military Academy, Dehradun, or the Air Force Academy at Bangalore. Hyderabad, correction, Air Force Academy Hyderabad, or the Indian Naval Academy Ezhimala. Ezhimala is in Kerala. Then on completion of the training at IMA or AFA or INA, these cadets or these gentlemen cadets get commissioned as an officer and on completion of this training, and then they are posted in their respective units. This is a simple thing which I have done based on the statistics. Who can do it? Who can join NDA? Boys above 80% marks in board examination. Friend, this is not a hard and fast rule. From my institute also, there have been boys who have joined NDA who got less than these marks, 70-75% marks, and still have been able to make it. But this is a general, on an average, the statistics says that most of the boys, say 90-95% of the boys, are having above 80% marks in the board exams. They should be good in mathematics. They should be good in social studies. They should be good in English. And they should be good in power of expression. This is my statistics, friends. Note, boys getting more than 80% in board exams only should be encouraged. This is a note basically for the teachers so that the right kind of students take on this profession. Now, other than NDA, what are the opportunities in defense? So, career in defense, that is after 12th, other than NDA. There is a 10 plus 2 technical entry in the Army as well as Navy. As far as the Army is concerned, it is twice a year again, April, May and September, October advertisement. And Navy also during the same time approximately. As far as the Army is concerned, the vacancies are either 90 or 105 or 150, depending the advertisement will give it. And the Navy, they generally don't announce, but you can say approximately 45 to 50 vacancies are there. Course commencement January and July for both. However, again, due to pandemic, here also, there have been delays in the commencement of the courses. Eligibility, here too, only the males are eligible. Friends, even though I have mentioned that the males are eligible for the NDA, for the CME, that is the technical entries for Navy and Army, the females are also likely to get inducted because last few years there have been even the ministers who have been mentioning, and even there has been an article which has come in the newspapers that the NDA gates are now open to girls. However, this thing has still not happened. The latest, as far as ladies joining the NDA is concerned, is that the Supreme Court has questioned the government of India, central government, as to why the girls are not permitted in the NDA. So friends, it is very likely that the girls may also be getting entry into the National Defense Academy. So these things will, however, take some time, and very likely that in a year or two or in the coming years, this thing is likely to happen. All right. So it is important for the girls also to know about it, because the minute it is open for the girls can also start preparing for this exam. However, the eligibility of educational qualifications would remain the same. Age at the time of application should be below 19 years, and at the time of joining the academy, it should be 19 and a half years. The qualifications, 12 science with 70% and above in PCM group, and the JEE mains merit. Same thing is for the Navy. Friends, remember that 70% is not difficult to score, difficult score in the 12 board exams. However, the JEE mains merit is important because the shortlisting is done based on the JEE mains merit. Now, as far as the Army is concerned, there are two entries I mentioned. One is the Army, one is the Navy. For the Army, those who get selected under this 10 plus 2 technical entry scheme, they get a basic military training of 1 year at Officers Training Academy, Gaya, followed by 4 years of technical training at College of Military Engineering, Pune, or Military College of EME, Secunderabad, or Military College of Telecommunication Engineering, Mahu. So these are the three engineering colleges of Army wherein you get a 4 years of engineering education. And on completion of the training, these students are awarded the engineering degree by Jawaharlal Nehru University. Friends, this I have mentioned, this training is of 5 years. However, you become officer on after completion of 4 years of training. So prior to your completion of your degree, you get commissioned as an officer 1 year prior to that. Okay. As far as the Navy is concerned, once you get selected, you undergo a 4 years BTEC course at Naval Academy, Azimala, Kerala. And again, the degree is also from the Jawaharlal Nehru University. This is for the girls as well as the boys, Armed Forces Medical College. Now here, males and females are eligible to apply. One should be below 22 years of age. However, the requirement is PCB, Physics, Chemistry and Biology from the 12th science batch. There are 145 vacancies, out of which 5 vacancies are for students of friendly countries. So, and out of 140, 30 girls vacancies are there. So 110 boys, 30 girls and 5 friendly countries vacancies. Now friends, what are the entries to join for the girls to join the Indian Armed Forces? Because they are at presently, they are not, they do not get entry to the National Defense Academy. Then how do they join? So all the entries for the girls are after their graduation. However, they are eligible to apply when they are studying in the final year of graduation. Now, one important point, it is not only the girls, but it is also the boys who are eligible to apply for these examinations. So let us proceed. One of the most important thing examination is the Combined Defense Service exam. We call it the CDS exam. This is also conducted by the UPSC like the National Defense Academy exam. Now the eligibility here is for the males and the females. Now, as far as the males are concerned, they can enter the Army, Navy and Air Force through this exam. However, the females can enter only the Army. For the Navy and the Air Force, they have separate examinations. Now, in this examination, the final year students are also eligible, whereas those who have completed the graduation are also eligible. The important point is the age for the permanent commission, that is for joining Indian Military Academy, age is below 23 years. So for joining IMA, it is 24. And for the short service commission, age is below 24 years. And for joining the OT, it is 25. For eligibility for applying is below 24. Got the point? Right. Now, here important point is girls are not eligible for permanent commission when you apply. So 23 permanent commission is only for the boys. For the girls, it will be 24 years. Got it? For Army, any graduate means graduate from any stream, that is you can say arts, science, commerce, BBA, BCA, BCS, any graduate, even a B-Pharm, BSc Agri. So any graduate is eligible, okay, for the Army. For the Air Force, again, any graduate. However, he should have done physics and maths till 12th. So if he has appeared, if he had done 12th science, 11th and 12th in science with physics and maths, then even if you have switched over from science to any other stream, he is eligible to join the Air Force. Okay, because it's for the flying stream. For the Navy, however, for the CDS exam, a boy has to be either a BE or a BTEC. Friend, for the Army, both CDS exam, males and females are eligible. For the Air Force and Navy, it is only the boys. Okay, so we move on further. AFCAT, this is an exam for entry to the Air Force. The long form is Air Force Common Admission Test. This test is conducted for entry to all the branches of the Indian Air Force. It is the flying branch and the ground duties branch. Now the ground duties branch has also got the technical branch as well as the ground duties. Okay, so we proceed. The flying branch, the age limit is 24. The technical and the ground duties is age limit is 26. Educational qualification. A very important issue, where everywhere you need an aggregate of 60% and above. So boys and girls should remember that throughout their career, they should get above 60%. Friends, it can be increased to 70% at a later stage if the applicants are more. So therefore, you need to have good score in your graduation and not only graduation, but during the entire course of your graduation. Flying branch, however, you need physics and maths at 10 plus 2, we have mentioned. Technical branch is BE/BTEC. For ground duties, for admin logistics, any graduate. Accounts, it is BCom or MCom or CA or ICWA. Whereas for the education branch, it is the post-graduation aggregate 50%. INET is Indian Naval Entrance Test exam. There are various branches like Naval Armament Inspection, CADA. It is for the males as well as the females. Now, then you have the air traffic control. Again, it is for the men and women. Then you have the pilot. It is again men and women. Friend, previously the pilot entry of the Indian Navy was not for the women, but now it is for the women as well. Now you have an observer entry, men and women. You have an engineering branch. Friend, for the engineering branch and the electrical branch, it is only for the men. And also for the education branch, again, it is for the men as well as women. Here it is only written men. We are for a particular advertisement. So you need to check up the advertisement for the education branch. Women are also there. Now, what is this INET exam consist of? It's basically MCQs, wherein English is there, reasoning and numerical ability is there, general science is there, mathematical aptitude is there, and general knowledge is there. There is a negative marking. Friends, is similar. The AFCAT exam is also similar examination, all right? But conducted by the Air Force authorities, this exam is conducted by the Indian Navy authorities. Whereas the CDS exam and the NDA exam are conducted by the UPSC. Now we move on further to defense as a career for women. This in basically in a nutshell, modes for entry for the Army. One entry is the NCC certificate, wherein any girl who has an NCC entry with C certificate having A or B grade is eligible. She should be below the age of 25 and should have a minimum of 50% marks in the graduation. There is another entry, technical entry, for which 27 is the age limit and the engineering graduates are eligible. Friends, for the technical entry, you need to ensure that the branch of engineering is important, and only if the advertisers mention your branch, only then you are eligible to apply. The next entry is the JAG entry, wherein all the law graduates, girls are eligible. These are also for the men also. However, I'm specifically now concentrating on the specific women entries. And the CDS exam, which we have already mentioned, it's also for the girl. So these are the four entries through which the women can join the Indian Army. Now, how they can join the Indian Navy? These are the five. There are five branches. Three are mentioned here. Two are on the next slide. Air traffic control, air card pilot, oblique observers, then information technology, then you have logistics, and you have the Naval Armament Inspection CADA. The degrees mentioned generally the engineering degrees are eligible for various entries of the Indian Navy. The age limit, however, is 25, and for the aviation, that is the being a pilot or the observer cadre, it is 24. The rest of the ages are 25. We move on to the Air Force. The entry for the Air Force is through the FCAT, Air Force Common Admission Test. All the three branches of the Indian Air Force, you are eligible. The girls, age limit, however, is either for flying is 24 and for other entries 26. Remember, 60% aggregate is a minimum requirement throughout, which is very, very important. All those who clear these various exams, whether it's NDA or the CDS or the FCAT or the INET, once you clear these exams, you are supposed to go through the SHB interviews. All those who qualify these written exams will be called for the SHB interview. Now, what is this SHB interview? The stage one. Stage one is basically the preliminary screening, that is the which consists of intelligence test, the picture perception test, and the group discussion. On the very first day, the candidates, the screening is conducted, and disqualified candidates will be sent home on the very first day. Candidates who qualify stage one will move on to the next stage, that is stage two of the SHB interviews. What is stage two? You have the psychological tests. You have the GTO test. What is the GTO? Ground testing officer. So there are basically, it is a group dynamism. The group dynamism is seen, how you behave in groups. Then is the interview. This is the personal interview. Then you have a conference. In the conference, a panel of officers is sitting. Interview, it is one-to-one. Whereas the conference, the panel of 10-12 officers are sitting around the table and you get into the hall. And just nominal, it is an interview of 2 to 3 minutes. Then on the same day, that is the fourth day, the results are announced. The very first day of the stage two psychological tests are there. The next 2 days, you have the GTO test. The interview is conducted on any of these 3 days mentioned for psychological test as a GTO test. The conference happens on the fourth day and the results also on the fourth day. A very, very important slide which I've made basically for you all. Students, you have to understand that what are these qualities and what are the things that they are seeing in the SHB interviews. There are three assessors friends in the SHB interviews. One is the psychologist who conduct the psychological test. The interviewing officer who conducts the personal interview, and the GTO, group testing officer, who is conducting the GTO test. All these three assessors or the three officers are looking in for certain qualities. So what are those qualities you need to understand? So these qualities, this is all in nutshell. I am not covering all the qualities, friends, but a few very important qualities which are there are, firstly, one should be patriotic. So now you have to understand that everybody is patriotic. We are all working towards the upliftment of the nation, and everybody is patriotic. Today, the most patriotic people are the doctors. They are serving the nation. Okay. So other than that, there is one very important quality, which is passion to join defense. Are you really keen to join defense? So a combination of being patriotic and passion to join defense is important. Leaders are also patriotic. Engineers are also patriotic. We are all doing something for the country only, right? Now the next point we move on is the sports. Sports is a plus point. Now, it does not mean that somebody who is not participated in sports cannot become an officer. It is not like that. Suppose somebody is weak in sports or has never participated in sports. He needs to understand that he lacks that quality and he needs to bring in or try to get into that over a period of time. Okay. Now, one of my students who joined the NDA had never played any game while studying in school. However, after joining the academy, he started playing a number of games. So there is no excuse. So sports is a part of the forces. All right. The next point is mentally strong. One needs to be mentally strong. What happens is physical strength is one part and the mental strength is another. One can be physically strong, however, need not be mentally strong. Here I am mentioning that mental strength is very important and more important than the physical strength. Why? Because once you join the academy, academy can make you physically tough, but academy cannot make you mentally tough. So mental strength is your own strength, friends. This is a very important quality which is required. The next point is extrovert. Being extrovert helps you to join the forces because you see all the sports persons, are generally extrovert. Because extrovert, why the quality is required? Because you need to get work done from men. And when you need to get the work done from men, the quality of mixing up with men, the quality of being a team person is very, very important. And that is going to help you to join the forces. The introvert people also can make it to the forces, provided they understand that they have this weakness and they try to overcome this weakness over a period of time. The next point is determination. You need to be determined to achieve success, friends. Not only in the NDA, but in life, throughout the life, whichever thing you want to achieve, you need to be determined. You cannot give up. So determination is one of the important qualities to rise up in life. Next point is inquisitiveness to get into details. Now this point, friends, what happens is many a times certain queries come to our mind. But what happens is, even though we have mobiles nowadays with the students, but that inquisitiveness is not there to find out about that particular word or get that information which we are not aware. However, you see, if there is something which is interesting you, then you would certainly get into the Google search and find it out. So it is a similar kind of a thing. So if you are not aware of certain things, there is no harm into getting into details. So that is one of the important qualities which is required. Last but not the least, friends, the general awareness. I mean to say, whatever things are happening in the country and around in the world, sports news, national news, international news, you should be aware. All right. Now, the certain interesting things which may interest you, friends, because a very, very important criteria for a person to make a career. The CTC for a lieutenant of the Indian Army or a sub-lieutenant of the Indian Navy or a flying officer of the Indian Air Force, their equivalent ranks would be approximately 1 lakh per month. Friend, if you are a graduate or an engineering graduate also today, the starting salary most of the times for 80% of the students is approximately 10 to 15,000 rupees a month. There are very few students who can get to the tune of 5 lakh or 6 lakh package, wherein the monthly salary is to the tune of 40, 50,000. That too, the engineering graduates would only get it. The commerce graduate, the arts graduate, the science graduate, you have to start with 8,000, 10,000, 12,000, isn't it? However, here, friend, the career starts with rupees 1 lakh. The other allowances are also there, friends. Transport allowance, outfit allowance, city compensatory allowance, field allowance, flying allowance, and so on and so forth. There are certain perks and privileges with the forces. For example, free rations, There are certain rations which come to your house daily basis. CSD canteen, all the day-to-day items required by you are available in these canteens at nominal rates. Furnished accommodation provided at nominal rates. Wherever you got, whichever station you go, you get posted, you get accommodation, and the rates are quite nominal. They are not like the rates which are there, existing rates in the cities. Then you have the facilities of officers, messes, clubs. State-of-the-art medical facilities are there, wherein you can now see the, because of the pandemic, they have started now asking help from the defense hospitals also. Okay. Actually, the defense hospitals are meant only for the Army, Navy and Air Force personnel. But because of the shortage, now we also have our own medical requirements. So the at this point of time, it's a tough time for the doctors. Now we then there are retirement benefits. It is the only organization, friends, wherein you are entitled to pension. And whether you believe it or not, today every officer retires in the rank of colonel minimum. There are few will retire at higher ranks also. Some will retire brigadier, some at major general, some at general. And you must also know that our present chief is from Pune. Okay, present chief is from Pune. And so the retirement pensions are different for different ranks. However, the minimum pension today for a lieutenant colonel, because that's a minimum rank at which an officer retires, is 1 lakh rupees. After cutting of the taxes by the government of India, he gets around 80-85,000 rupees in hand. All right. So the present scenario, friends. And in case you are interested in sports and adventure activities, here is a list of the various sports and adventure activities in the forces: billiards, squash, tennis, badminton, polo, horse riding, parasailing, hand gliding, rowing, sailing, trekking, mountaineering, skiing, and golf. We are almost coming to the end of our presentation, but before we close, we should know as to what courses are conducted at Apex Careers. Even though in the introduction, Madam has already mentioned what we are conducting, but at that point of time, you may not be attentive because in the beginning, before we start the presentation. So for all those who have not been attentive at that point of time, and all those who have also been attentive, just a brushing up of the courses conducted. We have a 2 years course of 11 plus 12 plus NDA. Then we have NDA crash courses, NDA regular courses, special courses, CDS courses, AFCAT, INET courses, and the SSB courses. So all the defense entries are there in the with Apex Careers. Now this is a common thing which is generally there. Do you have it in you? This is generally mentioned, friends, whenever you see an advertisement in the of the Indian Army. Now, this is my mobile number, friends, actually not only for the teachers. Yes, friend, this mobile numbers you can note down. The first number is incorrect. It is not. You can note down the second number. The first number is incorrect. The second number 9028221458 and mobile 9850880058. These are the two numbers, friends. 020 landline is not functional. 9028221458 and 9850880058. So with this, we come to the end of the presentation, friends. We now can take on the question answer session. Yeah,
thank you so much.
The presentation is over.
Forum is open for questions.
I am not able to hear you. Can you be a bit louder?
The forum is open for questions. So I urge people to give their questions, and I'll read out the questions to sir.
I am unable to hear you properly. There is a disturbance.
Am I audible to others?
Yes, sir. I can hear you.
Yeah. I can hear you, madam. I am not able to hear, sir.
Okay. We'll just try once. Otherwise, I'll pose the question to you.
Yeah, just a
minute. Yeah. Just give me a minute.
Can you hear me now? Sir, can you hear me?
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
All right, so I'm waiting for the questions.
Rajiv, sir, I've posted the questions in the drive.
Okay.
Yeah. So you can, Rajiv, sir, you can start. From the drive.
Sir, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Please carry on.
So the first question, sir, is it true that we can apply for the Air Force pilot's position once in a lifetime only? And why is that?
This is about the question of the Air Force, right?
That's correct, sir.
How many times is one eligible to apply? Am I right?
That's right, especially for the pilot's post, sir.
Pilot, yeah. What happens is, one can apply any number of times. The only thing is, once the boy or the girl clears the SSB, Service Selection Board, then he has to undergo a pilot aptitude battery test, which is known as the PABT. Now, this PABT test is conducted only once in a lifetime. So if that candidate clears the PABT, then he can join the flying branch. If he doesn't clear the PABT, then he joins the ground duties. That is the thing, number one. Number two, at times, before conducting of the SSB, they conduct the PABT test. This used to be done a few years back. Nowadays, they conduct PABT only for those students who qualify the SSB. All right?
Okay. I hope that answers the question. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
The next question, sir, is what is the difference between the Indian Military Academy and Officers Training Academy based in Chennai? And do we get to train? Do we get to choose our training centers?
Pardon. Second part, I did not understand.
So it's the second part is do we get to choose our training centers?
No, the first part I will answer because second part I did not get it. The first part is what is the difference between the Indian Military Academy and the Officers Training Academy? Firstly, all those cadets who pass out from the Indian Military Academy, they get a permanent commission. Except for certain like SL category and certain other there is one category which is the RC commission and all that, specialist officers and all that. Otherwise, all the officers who get into Indian Military Academy through NDA or directly to IME after graduation, they get a permanent commission. Now the permanent commission is entitled to a pension on retirement. All those officers who are granted short service commission, they go to Officer Training Academy for training. The girls are also going there and the boys are also going there. Officer Training Academy, Chennai. So all the and that there is a difference in the training period also. Suppose a graduate passes out, completes his graduation, moves to IMA, gets selected for IMA. He has to undergo 1.5 years of military training. Suppose he goes to OTA, he goes for only 1 year of military training. So as far as training is concerned, it is shorter. It is only shorter by 6 months. Means IMA, you go for a 1.5 years training. For the OTA, you go for a 1 year training. So that is another difference. However, those students, those cadets who pass out from NDA, and go to IMA, they undergo only a 1 year training. So I mentioned a few differences. Now, what is the second part? If you can repeat or if madam can repeat, because sir, your voice is not audible, please.
Okay. Okay, Matt, can you repeat that? Do we get to choose our training centers? So I think you answered that question.
Training centers, can you choose?
Training centers? Sir, I think you've answered the question. Do we get to choose? So we don't get to choose. It's based on the short service and the longer term, I guess.
Yeah, right. Now, the difference is in the application. When you apply, you see, if you applying for IMA as well as OTA, for IMA, you need to qualify three papers. The papers are English, mathematics, and general knowledge. Whereas for Officers Training Academy, you need to qualify for English and general knowledge. Mathematics is not compulsory. So those students who appear for all the three papers, but are not able to clear mathematics, they are also eligible to join OTA. So it is the examination orientation also. And accordingly, the boys get the admissions or they get selected for the courses at the various academies. Understood? Now, the Air Force Academy is purely for the Air Force. The entries are through the, for the boys, through the CDS as well as the FCAT. For the girls, the Air Force entry is only through the FCAT. For the Navy, the entries are through the, for the boys, entries are through the CDS and the INET exam. And for the girls, it is only through the INET exam. Got the point, sir?
Sure. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay.
So the next question is, if a person has a flat foot, can he go to RAW or in the defense after passing NDA exams?
No, you cannot shift over to RAW. RAW has got, you see, as far as NDA is concerned, we are training cadets to join the Indian Army, Navy and Air Force. There is no connection with RAW. It is a different organization altogether coming under the Home Ministry. The Army, Navy and Air Force are the defense forces, the Indian Armed Forces, which are coming under the Defense Ministry. So the anybody who is passing out from NDA or IMA or the Air Force Academy or the Naval Academy, we have no connection with the RAW or the IB. Right, sir?
Sure. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. The next question is it possible for someone to pursue their career in sports through defense, especially cricket?
Okay. We have, you have heard the name Colonel, who is now, what's his name? I'm not now recollecting, who is also a minister of sports, was a minister of sports or presently a minister of sports from Rajasthan, a colonel who was in the shooting team of the India, of a country. So sports, we also have an institute for sports. We have called it AIS, Army Institute of Sports, which is based in Pune. We also have the ASPT, Army School of Physical Training. However, let me be very honest, for officers, it is very difficult to pursue sports. For the jawans, it is still possible. For the officers, it is extremely difficult. The reason being, there is always a shortage of officers in a unit. And any unit for that matter, whether it is an infantry unit or an armored unit or an artillery unit or any unit for that matter, the authorized strength of officers is in between, is around 20 to 22 officers. And at any point of time, only 8 to 10 officers are posted, out of which another 2 or 3 officers are out on duties like some courses and various things. So physically, whereas when the requirement is of 20 or 22 officers, on ground, the availability of officers is only 5 or 6. So it becomes extremely difficult for the commanding officer to manage the show with a short number of, with a very small number of officers. And therefore, sparing an officer from the unit duties for sports becomes extremely difficult. Even though a few officers do get opportunities, even though we do promote that the officer should participate in games and all that, but all these things happen in the units, but sparing at a higher level or sparing for an India game or for the National Olympics, yes, we have a pride and privilege, but till the time somebody is showing an outstanding performance, it becomes extremely difficult for an officer to spare an officer. So the one cannot come out of from the totally be spared only for the games as far as the officer lot is concerned. I hope I have made the thing clear.
Yes, thank you so much for that, sir.
Yeah.
So there's one more question, a personal one.
Yeah.
Says Jai Hind, sir. I have spectacles and I have 0.25D exceeding than what is accepted in SSB medical. What should I do?
Specs.
That's correct, sir.
Okay. 0.25 is no problem. Now I will explain you the various requirements of the this physical requirements when they undergo a medical. As far as the boys are concerned, for NDA, for the Air Force and the Naval entries, they don't accept this thing, specs at all. Okay. But for the NDA Army, they accept the specs, the myopia of minus 2.5 and up to a plus 3.5 is acceptable for the entry to NDA. For girls, the permissible limit is minus 5.5. For the boys in the technical entries, the permissible myopia is minus 3.5. So it varies from service to service. So it will depend on which entry a person would like to go. For NDA Air Force, that is for Air Force flying and submarines, Navy, naval entry of the NDA, they don't permit specs at all. But other entries, a number of entries, the specs are permitted. As far as AFMC is concerned, specs are permitted. But for everything, there is a limit. All right. Is that question answered, sir?
Yes, thank you so much, sir. Okay. Ma'am, I would ask you if you have any questions, you can please go ahead and ask. Swapna, ma'am.
Yes, sir, Rajiv, sir, just a minute. So there's a very interesting question here, but I don't know whether one is authorized to answer. The one of our children says, sir, can you tell us the radio codes which are used in the Army forces?
Radio?
I didn't quite understand. Radio codes.
Radio codes?
Huh, codes, C-O-D-E-S.
Codes. No. Okay, I will explain. You see, firstly, these codes are all secret things. The codes are all secret things, and these are known only to the signals people who are responsible for the communication. Now you see, I will explain you a bit. In the Army, we have got different regiments. Like we have infantry, we have the fighting forces, which have infantry, mechanized infantry, and the armored regiments. We have got the supporting forces, the supporting arms, which consists of the artillery, the Corps of Engineers, and the Corps of Signals. Now we have the services, which consists of the Corps of EME, Electronics and Mechanical Engineers, Corps of ASC, Army Service Corps, and the Ordnance Corps, AOC. Now all these things put together form the Indian Army. In addition, there are, like, for example, medical. Army Medical Corps is also there. Even we have got Army Postal Corps. So all these things put together. Now the role of coding is all the role of the Corps of Signals, because the every corps and every regiment has its own role to perform. And it is the signals, Corps of Signals duty, the duties or the role of Corps of Signals is to provide communication to the entire army of the entire Indian Army. So the coding and decoding is done only by the core of signals. Got it? So as far as other regimens are concerned, they have nothing to do with this coding and non-coding of decoding of the radio sets. I hope the student is clear on this now.
I think so, sir. I hope so. Thank you, sir. Frederick Nietzsche, a German philosopher, has rightly said, "The essence of all beautiful art, all great and any art is gratitude." So on behalf of the staff, students and management of the Orbis School, we would like to express a profound gratitude to our eminent speaker for today, Lieutenant Colonel Brahmankar, for giving us an insight into the various vocational fortuities available in the Indian Defence Forces. We would also like to thank our heads of schools, Mrs. Nalini Samuel and Mrs. Gunjan Shivastava, for their relentless support and guidance. Lastly, but not the least, a heartfelt appreciation to all the parents and students who have attended this program today. Have a great day ahead. Stay home, stay safe. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you and all the best to all of you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.